automotive,
electronics, FMCG, food processing, and various industries are located here. And also, $4.5 billion investment. Export alone, nearly $4 billion. That is a very amazing experiment they have done. Global brands like Isuzu, Kobelco, Mandelja, PepsiCo, Kellogg's, Alstom, Foxconn, Colgate, Palmolive, and several more are all here. Always this area is very interesting area. One side Chennai, another side Nellur, Krishnapatnam, third side is Tirupati. These three places are also very important places. Chennai always 55 kilometers from here, one of the best urban infrastructure. And also we were all in Chennai once, Madras Presidency State. At that time, Andhra Pradesh, even Karnataka, South India, totally are in Chennai as the capital. And also Krishnapatnam, Nellore, you are having one of the best port. Chennai, there is a port. Krishnapatnam, there is a port. Tirupati, one of the best city emerging because of Lord Balaji, one of the most powerful God, I strongly believe it, living God in this century. So these are all, again, very, very excellent land, educational institutions. We can add some more for human resource development. All these things are available. So we wanted to work here to make one of the best economic zone you may not find anywhere. I want to create that. Equal to Shenzhen or better than that, all these things we are working in that direction. Even they have done very good work. They are able to recognize as on today, IGBC Golden Rating, sricity is on the track to upgrade now platinum by becoming entirely carbon negative. I told him just now while coming, whenever I come here, whenever I go anywhere, I am always evaluating critically. I ask him first question, what is the rainwater you are harnessing in this area? He told me around 60%. I asked him, at the earliest he had to do 100% rainwater harnessing has to be done in this premises, thereby greenery and so many advantages will come. That is where there won't be any water scarcity. Anyway, there is no water scarcity because this SEZ is very rich in all infrastructure facilities. Three airports, three ports for competition also from tomorrow onwards. Very good national highway connecting Tirupati, Chennai, Nellore. And also we are going to connect internal roads. And also three airports, Chennai, even Tirupati, one more airport in Nellore. All three airports are going to come. So these are all best infrastructure we are going to provide here. Here, I am very happy the way they are working. Most livable industrial zone I want to make it. Not only I asked him what is the temperature. By coming here, temperature should be less compared to outside. People should love to come here. That is how everybody will think industrial zone, industrial area will be very hot. Here 50% country's refrigeration or air conditioning you are providing here. Then why can't you make sricity itself naturally cooling? It is possible. Then it will be a reflection for your cooling the country. Just now I told all of you are here. I am giving you a good challenge. You are asking me cost-effective logistics, ultimately cost-effective production. For all these things, we need skills, capacities, and also everywhere you have to reduce efficiency, you have to bring, thereby you have to increase, enhance the productivity. Ultimately, production cost, logistics cost, we have to reduce as far as possible. I am with you. We will work in that direction. That is the main work we are doing now. From Andhra Pradesh, logistics cost should be very cost effective. That is how I am going to work in near future. Here we are building Amaravati, a new capital. Long back, I started 10 years back. One of the best concept, this is land pooling. Even I didn't spend even 1 rupee. 34,000 acres of land. 29,000 of farmers gave voluntarily under land pooling. It is a win-win situation. Now we want to go for district cooling, not individual units. Last time we had discussed with some partners also, we agreed also. Now we can come solutions, which is the best way, very cost effective, and also what is the best infrastructure we can create for district cooling. As on today, we are getting fiber at home, power to home, water to home, sewerage, all these things we are doing. 1, 2, 2. There also we are getting ducts, all these things. Ultimately, even AC should come through pipeline, not only gas. That is what we are working. You can come with the innovative idea, which country, which state has done extremely well. I wanted to know from all of you. Here, again, 62,000 people have created employment. That is a good gesture and also good way. Maximum employment we were able to create. 50% are women. Always we are focusing more on women empowerment. You have done this. I really thanking all of you. And also here investment in India. There are so many advantages. By 2029, India will become third largest economy. I am confident we can achieve before that. We are preparing now Vision 2047. 2047, India will become either number one or number two, that is our goal. We are preparing our vision document. For this, we are having some advantages. One is we are the first mover in information technology to adopt it. Now in information technology, we have gone up to artificial intelligence. That is the biggest advantage Indians are having. Second one, India fortunately had an occasion advantage of demographic advantage, dividend. Other countries, somehow they are unable to manage population, but naturally India got that advantage at this stage. Up to 2047, India will have this advantage. Our average age is 29 years. That is the biggest advantage we are having. Now I am talking about demographic management. From now onwards, South India, we are having a problem now. Population is declining. North India population is increasing. There is an imbalance. So I am talking now population management, increase more population. Without people, whom we can serve? Without people, your ACs, where it will go? There is population to service. That is where I am talking about it. I am confident. Earlier I had done population control. Now I am talking about population promotion. That is one policy. And also we are working linking of rivers. If we can do in India linking of rivers, then agriculture, we can feed the global community, huge chunk of land, all these things we are having advantages. Another area I am working, power, fuel. This is a new era we are going to witness in the near future. God blessed India with sunlight, now solar revolution. We are planning now hybrid model, solar, wind, pumped energy, battery, and also hydel, and also thermal, to get cost effective solution. That is where we are working. And at the same time, EVM, we are focusing more. And if you can go through totally, petrol, diesel, all these things are going to reduce drastically in course of time. Thereby, we can control pollution that is going to come in the near future. So what we are going, from then onwards, India is well positioned for green hydrogen and downstream industries. If you can go to green hydrogen, Andhra Pradesh is well positioned because of ports. In East Coast, nearly 1,000 kilometers coastline. Already we are having 6 to 7 ports. We are increasing another 3 ports. We are going to construct another 7 airports are there, another 5, 6. And we wanted to connect from village to port, marketplace, headquarter, everywhere. That is how we are planning infrastructure in a big way. So with all these things, again, employment is very crucial. This type of population, we want to create more and more employment. We want to focus on employment generation and also product perfection. This is also an important issue. India is working now. How to make product perfection? That is another exercise. For all these things, we are going skill census first of its kind in India. Even some of the countries may not have done this. Every citizen, we are having 5 crore population, working population 3.74 crores. I wanted to go for skill census, thereby globally what is the required skills for 20 years from now onwards, how to integrate backward for skill upgradation and human resource development. Nowadays, technologies are coming. IoTs, even cell phone is exactly 25 years back, I used to talk about cell phone. Then everybody used to heckle me, cell phone can feed anybody. Today, cell phone has become a necessity for everybody. Now, apps have come, analytics have come, artificial intelligence is a reality, drones have come, either pest detection, pest control, mosquito control, road condition evaluation, anything for that matter. Even buildings, construction, quality, inspection, everything. It is a new era, new world we are going to live in the near future. So with all new approaches we are coming, there we are aiming 15% growth rate next 25 years. There I need investment, industrial friends in a big way, and also finally zero poverty also I am planning. This is where, if you can see in India, we are creating wealth because of economic reforms P3 formula, public private people's partnership. Now because of this we are able to create wealth, government is getting some revenue, but at the same time disparities of economic inequalities are increasing. Now that is where we are talking about zero poverty. Top 10%, even industrial friends, can adopt bottom 20%. Mentoring, hand-holding, helping, short-term, medium-term, long-term. We have to take into consideration people as capital. We are all politicians. Issue is, we have to run in democracy political governance. My stakeholders are public and also industry and others, everybody, employees, everybody. I have to balance everybody. This is the new concept we are taking. There also I need your cooperation, how to work it out, how to eradicate poverty, how to empower continuously last mile who are all really suffering. And ultimately, these are all few thoughts I want to share you. In this area, even some of our friends, Japanese firms, they told me power incentives, power quality, property tax, acceleration, and also to improve public governance, improve transparency, accountability, EDV, road shows to Japan, Korea and US to attract investment. Isuzu again he invited me to come to Japan, certainly, and also Daikin Global Air Condition Exports from Sricity. Skilling, he referred about skilling in a big way. That is one more request he has done. For the last 5 years, my successor never visited this place. That itself is an indication you don't know the value of investment. Generally, in India also, not all, majority are working for investment and creating employment. We used to compete with each other. There were days, states used to compete with each other. If you go back 20 years back, only Bangalore city was IT presence. India, IT means only Bangalore. Then I challenged Bangalore. Then I want to promote investment to Hyderabad. At that time, my counterpart used to counter me, how can you attract investment to Hyderabad? Hyderabad is nowhere in the map of IT. Then I made one by one company. Ultimately, he gave a statement, I cannot compete with you, we will work together. This is where we have to compete, complement with each other for a healthy competition, then only things will happen. Today, Hyderabad is better or equal to Bangalore. Everything is possible. All these things have happened for the last 25 years time only. Huge incentives are pending, I am aware. I was inherited very bad treasury. There is no money, but we will create wealth at the earliest installment wise. I will release all your incentives. That is my commitment. I will do it. And also infrastructure gaps such as road, industrial water, power. This is another issue is there in for industries, that also will do. Even irrational high tariffs, even water, they increased abnormally. I have seen that. And also other inputs also. I am assuring you, immediately we will rationalize. Very soon I am going to bring a policy. There I am giving very clear clarity for all of you. We will do it. We will reduce. We will bring competitive price. Even original price what you have given at that time. That is how I am going to get that price, that policy also. Even fees and charges, I told you, this is where you are asking here, property tax. That also will control, will rationalize, will do that also. And also law and order, today I have started on police station here, one of the best police station. Even in Hyderabad at that time, I started on police station Cyberabad. Even now it is better than that. With the modern equipment, everything, we are going to provide one of the best police station. And also, you don't have any problem of law and order. That is my assurance. If I come, automatically law and order will be controlled. I was inherited some problems, drugs, ganjai, rowdyism, criminalization, all these things, but I am ruthless. I made it very clear, zero tolerance on law and order. I will implement and I will execute, I will maintain law and order, that is our commitment. And also, some more, here only, I brought at the time one institute, one of the best autonomous body. They brought their reservations. This is a very, sometimes, irrational also. We have to help everybody. There is a way of educating, there is a way of accommodating, or otherwise they are competitive, then we can do one thing. We'll give visas, everything. This that is not the way, but that also I will think over how to do it. Even here, I wanted to go for skill development in a big way. Required skills I can provide. And I am requesting all of you to recruit local people as far as possible. You are doing that. 90% you are doing that. But they brought one act, 75% mandated for local people. This type of things may not help us. By creating competitive spirit, skill development, automatically, compared to other states' persons, here, labor and productivity is more efficient, you will engage local people only. This type of acts also we are reviewing, we'll take some action. Finally, some of the industrialists, at least you are here, every year, our fire department, they are giving permission every year. I used to give once in 5 years. I used to introduce so many regulations at that time, deemed class also. Sometimes some officer may not give permission. Then you have to go on meeting him, all these things. Okay, one day my application I have given, 30 days. After 30 days, deemed permission class I introduced. Even today, straight away, I'm telling you, fire department, all industries, not every year, I will restore once in 5 years, they have to renew it. Then only freeness will come, easy way of doing business will come. Last time, you can recollect. Ease of doing business, we are number one. Not 1 year. 4 years, we are number one continuously. During my tenure, nobody can compete with me on ease of doing business, other states. Always somebody is doing better, I will do still better. There is a scope. That is how we have to compete. Now I am talking of speed of doing business, not only ease of doing business. We have to go for speed of doing business. How to speed it up? Your renewals, permissions, or service, any services we have to provide, all these things I want to do it. And also cost of production, cost of logistics reduction, how to do it. Cost effective solutions, how to bring it. This also will focus, and ultimately Andhra Pradesh will be a preferred and also very good destination for all of you. Once you land in Andhra Pradesh, you will be very happy, you will be safe, and you will get better profits compared to any other area. That is how we want to create this place. I really appreciate all of you for giving me this opportunity. We are going to create all policies within another 20 days time. 100 days, recently I called CAI and other business organizations. I spent time with them. Even Tata chairman Chandrasekhar has accepted to be the co-chairperson of Investment Promotion Board. I will be the chairperson, you will be the co-chairperson, so that all eminent industrial friends I want to invite, create excellent policies, and also execute all these things and review periodically, so that we will have good advantage. So this type of new ideas, I am coming here. Anytime you wanted to meet, you can meet me. We'll have a detailed interaction also, if necessary, some more brainstorming that will help us win-win situation. With this, I'm always, by meeting you, I will forget about my time. But at the same time, I will recollect again. Time is moving. I have to go to some other program. I have to balance everything. With this, I wish all the best. What all I'm doing, I need your cooperation and also your participation. With this, I thank all of you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. You also have become our chief marketing officer, sir. No, I don't think we can even present ourselves better than what you have presented, sir. We want to take this opportunity to sign 5 MOUs in your presence. These 5 MOUs are going to invest 1,200 crores in Andhra Pradesh. We are generating about 4,000 employment. One of them is also Daikin. So with your permission, we'll call them, sir. Please.
We welcome Amvis Mirai Tech India Private Limited. Hakoda-san, please take the chance. Amvis Mirai Tech is a Singapore and Indonesian company. We welcome Excellent Pharma Science Private Limited, please. Keep it open. We welcome Capman India Industries Private Limited. We welcome Daikin India Private Limited. We request PI Prestige International India Private Limited to come forward, please. Sir, on... Sir, your vision and leadership has been very instrumental in driving the state forward, sir. Sir, we all promise you, sir, that we'll be creating many more sricity cities in the state.